Billionaire Elon Musk changes course again and is now proposing to go ahead with his original offer to buy Twitter for $44 billion. This will potentially end the legal fight over whether the billionaire could pull out of the agreement struck nearly 6 months ago. To recall, Musk offered to buy Twitter back in April at $54.20 per share, but he abandoned the deal in July, with his lawyers saying Twitter failed or refused to respond to multiple requests for information on fake or spam accounts on the platform. This prompted the social media giant to sue Musk to force him to push through with a deal. Twitter has yet to accept his new proposal, but it reportedly plans to add conditions to try to ensure that Musk does not change his mind again. Scientists and tech professionals protesting the mandatory SIM registration bill. They warn this will lead to more harm than good. Warren De Guzman tells us why.
The Computer Professionals Union and AGHAM, or Advocates of Science and Technology for the People, protest the mandatory SIM registration in Mendiola Tuesday. The measure may soon be signed into law by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., but the groups warn it will only lead to more crimes.
Napatunayan na sa ibang mga bansa na nag-implement ng SIM card registration na hindi ito epektibo sa pagpigil sa krimen. Bagkus ay dumami pa nga ang mga krimen dahil sa SIM registration. Mula sa pagnanakaw ng mga SIM card, sa pagbebenta o sa pagkakaroon ng black market ng mga illegal na SIM card, at lalo na sa identity theft na ginagamit sa iba pang mas malalang mga krimen.
Regulators admit cybercriminals are very innovative. For example, vishing, wherein fraudsters call the victim to steal information, a workaround after the use of links in text messages was banned to put a stop to smishing attacks or scam texts. ABS-CBN revisited Fatima Chang, who has been victimized by various forms of cyber attacks. She shares she received a call from a cyber criminal while watching a live stream on social media, which was giving out cash prizes. The caller claimed to be connected with the live streamer and promised to give her a prize in exchange for personal data and a one-time password from her e-wallet. Fatima was thankful she only had 100 pesos in her account.
Tuwa naman ako. Biruin mo naman, bibigyan ka 5,000. Biglang nag-off, tawag siya uli. And then sabi niya, ayaw na sumagot, pero naka-on yung cellphone ko. And then yung pala, kinuha na yung laman ng GCash ko.
Cantilla says it's hard to fight these kinds of cyber attacks on an individual level.
Hindi natin matukoy kung saan nanggagaling itong mga kumakalat na information natin kasi hindi well enforced yung Data Privacy Act. For example, itong pandemic, diba, ang daming mga contact tracing forms na hindi natin alam kung saan naman talaga ginagamit.
But they stress SIM registration is still not the solution. Instead, they recommend the review and strengthening of the Data Privacy Act, which was passed in 2012. They also argue that it has not been implemented well by government.
It seems na hindi active yung NPC sa pag-ensure na yung mga data policies and yung mismong enforcement ng policies na yon ay umaayon sa Data Privacy Act.
The National Privacy Commission and the Department of Information and Communications Technology support SIM registration. They have yet to react to claims they have been remiss in the implementation of the Data Privacy Act. Based on that law, any information that is not needed for whatever transaction or service being applied for should not be collected, with the exception of information needed during times of national emergencies. In other words, contact tracing apps may be allowed to collect very specific personal data during a pandemic, but private companies and local government units should not be doing the same in any other circumstance, especially if they cannot protect the information being collected. Large telcos also support the SIM registration, but they have also repeatedly advised the public to be careful with personal information and to report all numbers used in cyber attacks so they can't be used again. Complaints can be forwarded to the NPC, the National Telecommunications Commission, and the telcos themselves. Warren De Guzman, ABS-CBN News.